Hey Art Family, if you like this one, there's a full-length version on Patreon.
They are skillful.
Hello Art Family, and thank you to all the new subscribers. For this video, I decided to do a sketch of a movie theater in Lawrenceville, PA, which is a part of Pittsburgh that I really like. We went there not too long ago to see the movie Porco Rosso because they had like a Miyazaki week-long kind of marathon that they were doing. The day we went, it was very rainy, and the initial shot was shot wide, and there was a lot of stuff off to the right, and I had been planning on doing the sketch, but I held off for a long time because I couldn't quite get the sketch right based on the photo reference, and then I realized that everything off to the right wasn't really what I was interested in, and I didn't feel like it really benefited the kind of composition, and essentially what I had was two paintings next to one another. I had stuff to the right and stuff to the left, and they didn't really connect or support one another. So I cut off the stuff to the right, because I liked the stronger L-shape composition that I got here, having a strong vertical element and a strong horizontal element. I'm working 16 inches by 20 inches on an Arches watercolor block, cold pressed, and I'm using a wax Prismacolor pencil right now, which you can see as I'm going, I'm making a whole lot of mistakes trying to get the perspective and the scale correct. I'm trying to find the sort of rhythms where these things line up in two-dimensional space on the plane. So where does the roof of the building to the right line up against whatever kind of objects are off to the left? So I can sort of find these rhythms and place these things all together. And I had to move some stuff, but I'm not that worried about it because for me personally and my watercolor sketches, I like having remnants of pencil left behind, which is why I switched to using a wax pencil in the first place. It's just something I've always liked. There's something about like the old Disney Xerox era of Disney, like 101 Dalmatians, where you can occasionally see the frames pop through of like, say, Milk Calls, you know, all the grid and structure of the characters that like will flash through for a moment. I always really enjoyed that. So I like having that in my own watercolor paintings. So initially I did a quick sketch that just figured out my big shapes of value, and then also just a quick sketch of the different figures that were going to be involved in the scene. After that, I used a 2-inch hake brush that I really like. I did a lot of this painting using squirrel brushes. This is the largest squirrel brush I have, and hake brushes. I really like using a flat brush, and I've recently got into using hake brushes because they're nice and big and flat. They don't hold a very precise line, as precise as I kind of would think they would, being that they're flat, but I do really like that they can hold a lot of water and that they're very soft. So I start off by just washing clean water over the whole image, except for a couple tiny pockets for highlights. But even if I mess those up, I'm not really concerned about it because I can come back with white gouache later. And then I want to get an overall gradient going from slightly dark using ultramarine blue and burnt sienna back and forth, varying from warm to cool. I'm going to go down darker to lighter for the atmosphere and then darker again as it gets closer to me. And then I use the hairdryer. I also took advantage of that first wash to get in those lighter elements like the light on the sign. And now at this stage I'm working on this second layer of value, and I want to find that middle value that kind of connects the right to the left side. So I'm kind of looking underneath the darker values that I'm going to come back in and concern myself with later, and I'm just looking for that middle value. If you close one eye and squint at the reference, you can see it groups very nicely across the whole picture plane. There's just a general darker value. Everything is much darker than the sky and the ground. So I want to try to pitch this all relatively dark, but keeping this kind of loose because I want to make sure everything in this feels very wet and damp. I want to make everything kind of soft. So a lot of the edges I want to keep very soft because I want to give the sense of atmosphere, the sense or the feeling that it's rainy, and that there's a lot of reflections, and that there's just a general softness to all these different shapes where the shapes meet one another. It all kind of creates a sort of haze. I'm using a spray bottle often because I want to keep these areas wet, and as I'm working in these darker bits and shapes, I'm going back to that same principle of closing an eye and squinting at the reference, or as if I was outdoors, I would close an eye and squint at what I was looking at, and just trying to keep these areas wet and placing in the vague general shape. I'm not trying to render these trees or the different cars and stuff that are going on in the background. I just want to keep them soft, but have them snap enough to the sort of arbitrary perspective grid so that you still get this sense of depth to the image. On a couple of these reflections that I put in very wet using the spray bottle, I dragged a dry paper towel across them on that perspective grid as well, just to try to reinforce that three-dimensional feeling in the sense that this scene is going back into the distance. And it's the same thing you kind of get from where the tires tread across the wet road and that sort of thing. You get this sort of highlighted, not quite highlighted, but a lighter plane that sort of runs in the perspective of the road. For the cars, I'm trying to not think about them as cars and more just as a general shape. I have basically a kind of tissue box sitting there with a top plane and the side planes, and then a darker shadow underneath. Once I place in the large dark shapes underneath the car, I spray it directly with a spray bottle just to give that very loose, long kind of shadow plus reflection onto the wet road, before adding in some darker elements as well. So I set myself up earlier with those lighter yellows and colors in the sign, and with the street signs as well, so that I could come in now and start to chisel away some of those forms, giving the kind of relief of the sign and the streetlights as well. Now I'm using a sable brush, which holds much less water than the squirrel brush. I probably should have used the squirrel brush to get over this much larger area, but I went with the sable brush and I'm spraying it often, and I'm just varying from warm to cool. Most of this sketch is ultramarine blue and burnt sienna, and then the greener areas are yellow ochre or yellow ochre added to those mix to create a kind of dull green. I tried to let the lighter value be the window shapes by negative painting around for the higher windows, and then these lower windows, I used my spray bottle to make sure that it was wet and painted those shapes in, just trying to set those shapes in, still wet, sitting against the wet, just using much less water so it wouldn't burn, but allowing those edges to be soft. Because this is a 20-inch, this is like an 18-inch pole I'm trying to draw in here, so if this was a sketchbook, I would use probably scribe it with my pinky, so that means just running your smaller finger against the edge of your sketchbook while holding your pencil tightly to get that straight line. But in this case, I used a ruler and I gripped it with my knuckles set against the page. I pull so that the water doesn't get pulled under the ruler and ruin your sketch. So I dragged the brush across the end of that to get at least the straight line, and then I could come back and clean it up later. Now I'm adding in these darker elements, and I'm getting into the final stages of this sketch where I feel like I am content with the major shapes, which is my biggest concern. And then I can start to put in some of these smaller details and start to concern myself with the figures in the scene. I want to keep the figures loose, but they are a crucial element to give scale and to give a kind of human aspect to a painting that people can sort of relate to. I'm only really concerned about the measurement of the halfway point of the rectangle they sit in so that I can draw them in perspective, keeping their heads about the same height, and then finding the feet, the halfway point being the hips, so I have the upper body and then the legs sort of loosely stroked in to give the sense that they're walking. I'm using some white gouache to highlight areas and clean up the sketch, and then now just using a needle brush to get in the telephone poles and the last couple bits of detail that I want to add. Well, that's going to be it for this sketch of a rainy day in Lawrenceville, Pennsylvania. I appreciate you watching, and I look forward to seeing you in the next video. In the meantime, happy sketching.